So once again, good morning friends. Today the another crop we are going to study the production technology of papaya. Papaya it is known as a Carica papaya, it is the scientific name, and Carica is the family, and it is the origin of this tropical America. Okay, papaya, that is a Carica papaya, produces the fruits throughout the year. It requires less area for the tree and comes to the fruiting in a year, is easy to cultivate and provides more income per hectare next to the banana. It is having a high nutritive as well as medicinal value, friends. And papain, that is a extract from the papaya, it is very important. So papain prepared from the dried latex of this immature fruits of this papaya is used in the meat tendering, manufacturing of the chewing gum, as well as for the cosmetics as well as pharmaceutical uses. It is the fifth most important crop in the India, so this crop is very much important. Papaya is the most popular because of the few reasons why it is most popular among the farmers, because it is having a short duration, so that within a shortest period it gives the maximum income and with the minimum area. It gives the high yielding, more income and high palatability and continuous bearing throughout the year. So these are the five reasons why papaya is popular among the farmers. It is rapidly growing hollow stem, short-lived perennial and herbaceous plant. It is grown largely in the Bihar, Assam, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. In Gujarat, all the regions except Dang and Banaskantha, it is grown successfully throughout the Gujarat. In the Gujarat, 3400 hectare of the area is occupied by the papaya crop, and having yield of the 1,70,000 metric tons in the Gujarat. Now among the uses, the ripe fresh fruit of the papaya are eaten throughout the tropics and subtropics. They are used in the preparation of the jam, soft drinks, ice creams, flavorings, and then crystallized fruits, and in the syrup. The seeds are also used for their medicinal value, and unripe fruits are commonly used as vegetable purpose or for the cooking. Young leaves are eaten in Java as a vegetables. Papain, that is prepared from the dried latex of immature fruit, is protective enzyme similar in the action to the pepsin in the body, and it is used as meat tendering preparations in the manufacturing of chewing gums, cosmetics. As we have discussed earlier, it is having a lot of nutritive value as well as uses. Now, which type of climatic conditions are favorable for the papaya, so that we can make the papaya very much economical and successful crop in the state? So let us see. Papaya is the tropical fruit, and however, it grows well in the mild subtropical regions of the country up to the 1000 meter above the mean sea level. Temperature is the one of the most important climatic factor which determines the success of the papaya cultivation. Night temperature below 12 to 14 degrees Celsius for several hours during the winter season affects growth and production of the papaya crop. Very sensitive, this crop is very much sensitive to the frost, strong winds and water stagnation at the base of the papaya. And papaya cannot tolerate very hot or the frost. So papaya is very much sensitive among as far as climatic conditions are concerned, and dry, warm and climate, warm climatic conditions increase the sweetness in the papaya crop. So this is all about the climatic conditions of the papaya. And among the soils, sandy loam soils, well fertile and well drained, is the best for the papaya crop. Adequate drainage and aeration are two most important factors for successful cultivation of the papaya crop, and 45 centimeter deep soil is adequate for the papaya and cannot stand waterlogging condition. So waterlogging condition is we can say very much detrimental, or you can say having a negative effects on the production as well as growth of the papaya. So water stagnation should be avoided. Among the varieties, a large number of the varieties are cultivated throughout the country. As a matter of the fact, many of these are not real varieties, since this cannot be relied upon the reproduce the parental characteristics in all their progenies. However, well-known varieties with certain specific plant and fruit characters are described here: Washington, Madhubindu, Kurg Honey Dew, CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4, Pusa Delicious, Pusa Majestic, Pusa Giant and Pusa Dwarf are the varieties which are grown throughout the country successfully in different states. So, these are the different characteristics of different varieties. So, you can as I have provided the soft copy of this material, there is a word as well as this PDF files to you. So, one by one variety you can go through and you can study the characteristics of different varieties of this papaya. So, let us see one by one. Pusa Delicious, it is gynodioecious variety with 100% of the productive plants and good fruit yield is there and quality and excellent taste and good flavor. Pusa Majestic, Pusa Giant, Pusa Dwarf, these are the varieties, and Pusa Giant, this dwarf variety, statute dioecious variety, good yield, fruits are medium sized with oval shape and are preferred by the consumers. Pusa Nana is also the one of the variety which is extremely famous in the, among the farmers, and CO1. So, these are the different shapes of the fruits which are available on the papaya plant. And with the help of these different shapes, we can distinguish the different varieties. See, Pusa Delicious, these are the fruits of Pusa Delicious, these are the fruits of Pusa Nanha, these are the fruits of Pusa Majesty. CO2, CO3, CO4, CO that means stands for the Coimbatore. So, Coimbatore 1, Coimbatore 2, 3, 4, Coimbatore 5, Coimbatore 6, these are the different varieties released from the Coimbatore. Okay, these are the different fruits. CO1, these are the CO2, CO3, CO4, 5, 6 and CO7, these are the fruits of these different varieties. Now, Coorg Honeydew, it is a selection from the honeydew. It is a gynodioecious variety having excellent fruit quality under the South Indian conditions. While it is a pink flesh sweet, it is selection with the excellent quality fruit. Fruits are medium size and in pink in the flesh, flesh is pink. The TSS is 12 to 14 degree bricks and it is good desert variety. Then Pant 1, this it is also one of the famous variety. This is the these are the fruits of the Coorg Honeydew. Okay, as far as propagation is concerned, papaya are generally propagated commercially through the help of the seeds. The most common method is the seeds only. It is collected from the well matured ripe selected fruits, washed and dried under the shade and stored in a bottle or plastic bag. Immediate sowing gives the maximum germination. So, when we are storing the or store the papaya seeds for a longer period, the germination percent may be reduced. So, it is advisable to sow the papaya seeds immediately or at the earliest. Now, patch budding is also one of the commercial, we cannot say commercial one of, but we can say it is one of the propagation method in the papaya. It is possible with very less success. So, generally for the research based scientists are using this method. And raising of the seedling, how we can do it? So, 500 gram of the seeds are required per hectare. Raised bed prepared seeds are sown 1 centimeter depth, they are 1.5 by 2.5 centimeter spacing, covered with a fine mixture of the FYM, that is farmyard manure, plus soil, and immediate watering is required. Mulching with dry leaves are also advisable for this better germination of this crop. Covering thorny material, it is also advisable. Seeds will germinate in 15 to 20 days. Seedlings are ready in 60 days for the transplanting in the another field. Bordex mixture is advised to spray against the damping off, that is 3:3:100 in the initial stage of the papaya seedling. Now, let us go for the planting at the 2.5 by 2.5 meter spacing, or you can say distance planting of this transplanting of this papaya seedlings are done after the 60 days of the papaya seedling preparation. So, after the sowing of the seeds, we can after 60 days we can go for the planting, or you can say transplanting. So, pits of the 30 by 30 by 30 centimeter are dug in the summer season and filled with the soil and farmyard manure, that is 3:1 ratio. Planting in the July to August, it is more advisable. For the Saurashtra region, May is the best season for the transplanting. Generally, 3 seedlings are planted at each pit at 20 centimeter apart and give the support and irrigation immediately after the sowing, or you can say transplanting. For dioecious variety, there is CO1 and CO2 and Washington, 3 seedlings are planted. For hermaphrodite varieties, 2 seedlings are planted, and there is Coorg Honeydew, Pusa Majesty, Pusa Dwarf and Pusa Giant. generally in the initial phase wedding is very much problematic for the growth of the papaya, but for the better growth of the papaya seedlings. So wedding and hoeing are required as per the requirement. We have to go for this operations in the initial phase. Now earthing up is also one of the most important operation after 15 days of the planting. Light digging after 3 to 4 irrigations is advisable for the successive growth of this papaya. Okay, these are the fruits or flowers of the female, and this is the flower of the male. So generally, this type of spadix type, this structure is found in this male plant, while this female are directly attached to the stem. So removal of the male plant is very important, because these are the only for the pollination. We require the male plants only for the pollination. So one male plant is kept for the every 9 female. So we have to keep in a single line 9 female plus 1 male, so that it is sufficient for the pollination. Other males are to be removed after the flowering, so that after flowering we can come to know whether this plant is male or female. So by maintaining the ratio of 1:9, we have to remove the male plants. As far as irrigation is concerned, it responds well to the irrigation, so frequent irrigation is required. Sensitive to the water logging conditions, so we have to take care that water stagnation, or you can say water logging condition, must not be created in the field where papaya are grown. Double basin system is the best for the prevention of the collar rot. While in the winter 10 to 12 and in the summer season 6 to 8 days interval, we have to give the irrigation. So frequent irrigations are required, but at the same time we have to take care that there is no water logging condition in the papaya plants. Now manure and fertilizer application for the continuous fruiting and in this crop and for the heavy yield, FOM is the best source of the nutrients for this papaya. So this is the field. Irrigation and mulching operations are given in this papaya field. Okay, now as far as fertilizers are concerned, there is a one schedule which one farmer should maintain regularly and precisely for the better production as well as for the better quality. So this is the time of application at the planting at 1 month interval, 3 months, 4.5 months and 6 month interval. So in the initial phase, at the time of the transplanting, we have to give the 10 to 15 kilogram of the FOM per pit, or you can say per plant. While at the time of the planting, or you can say transplanting, phosphorus and potash are also to be applied 100 and 150 gram per plant. While after 1 month, this nitrogen is to be given in 4 split, that is 1 month, 3, 4.5 and 6 months, 50 grams per plant. While phosphorus and potash are to be given 2 times, that is at the planting time and at the time of the 3 months, 125 gram of the phosphorus and potash per plant. So finally, we can say the dosage of the papaya fertilizers as well as manure, that is 10 to 15 kilogram of the FOM, 200 gram of the phosphorus and 250 gram of the potash are required for the better cultivation, better growth, quality as well as maximum yield in the papaya. Now intercropping, obviously vegetables and pulses are desirable, or you can say advisable for this crop. Now harvesting is very much important in this papaya, so we have to take some care during the harvesting. So which are the signs for the harvesting? So fruit color changes from green to the yellowish green, so this is the sign at which we can harvest the fruits. Latex becomes watery at the time of the harvesting. So in the initial phase, latex is very much thicker, but with the progress of the papaya fruit, we can say latex becomes watery. So at the end, when there is a time of the harvesting, watery latex is appearing, so that we can judge that this fruit is ready for the harvesting. Fruit becomes ready after 10 to 12 months of the transplanting and remains continuous throughout the life. 40 to 60 tons per hectare is the yield in the papaya. So every 25 to 30 fruits per plant as are generally we are harvesting, and each of the 500 gram of the fruits to the 2 kilogram of the fruits we can harvest per plant. So 40 to 60 tons per hectare is the yield of the papaya. Now picking, storage and ripening, these are the 3 important operations in the papaya. So for the local consumption, stored in a single layer on the straw, by this method we can store. For the distance market, packed in the basket with straw, sometimes wrapped in the newspapers, and 20 degree Celsius is optimum temperature, which is best for the papaya shelf life. And ethiopon treatment, when we are giving with the 1000 ppm, we can hasten the ripening, we can bring the early ripening to the papaya fruits. Okay, so these are the different stages. Initially green, 25% color change, 50%, 75%, and full color. So I have taken this from some website, and I thanks for this picture to them. Okay, this is the papaya field, and these are the persons which are harvesting these papaya fruits. Okay, so now among the pest disease, nematode is one of the important disease in the papaya, and pest in the papaya. So nematode is highly papaya is highly susceptible to the papaya nematodes, and apply carbofuran 3 gram and aldicarb 10 gram per pit for the control of the nematodes. And mealybug is also one of the this is the plant having a maximum incidence or you can infestation of the mealybug. So small white tiny bugs suck the sap from the tender plants, and treatment of the soil with the aldrin or thymet is the important for this control of this crop, this pest. So these are the two important pests. Among the disease, collar rot is this is the collar rot. So this is in comes on in the initial phase. Second is the root rot. So you can see the infestation of this root rot, and wall of the orchard, we can say wall orchard is infected, and finally we can we have lost this orchard. Okay, this papaya mosaic is also very much important and very much we can say tedious job for the control of this disease, and farmers are generally having main problem in this papaya. For this papaya mosaic, plants are stunted, yellowing, mottling, and distortion of the leaves, bending of the petiole. For the control of the of this papaya mosaic, we can control the vector, that is a aphid. So this is the control measure for this papaya mosaic. Okay, papaya leaf curl is also one of the disease found in the papaya. So this is also viral disease. Okay. Among the sex expression, this is the dioecious plant. Three types of the flowers are there: pistillate, seminate, and hermaphrodite flowers. Sex change is can be accelerated by environmental factors. There is low temperature produce the perfect flowers on the male trees, and pistil flowers shows maleness in the summer and femaleness in the winter, and in the February planting shows more female. March and April produces equal. So early flowering during the early sowing during the February is advisable. And spray of the GA3, there is a gibberellic acid, at 25 ppm after 100 to 125 days produce the more number of the female. So these are we can little bit change in the expression of the sex of the male and female we can do. Now what is pepin and how we can extract it? So let us see. The immature papaya fruits contain a milky latex. The dried latex called pepin is in great demand in the world, in the international markets, and popularly it is used in the UK and USA. Pepin has several uses in industry as an essential ingredient in the pharmaceuticals, textiles, tanning industries. Pepin is used in the tanning meat for clearing beer, in the manufacturing of the cosmetics like snows and face creams, and also dental paste in the degumming silk and rayon, in the pre shrinking of the wool. So this is having a lot of uses. So it is it has also several uses in the medicinal medical field, in the treatment of the necrotic tissues, dyspepsia, and other digestive related disease. Pepin is used in the detecting stomach and intestinal cancers, and also in the correcting the diphtheria. So pepin production is influenced by several factors, that is a fruit size, fruit maturity, season, and cultivars. So which cultivars we are using, at in which season we are transplanting, as well as we are harvesting, and what is the stage of the maturity as well as size of the fruit. So generally these are the factors which are influencing the production of the pepin. So CO2 is the best variety for the pepin production, we can say, and effect of the growth regulator is also found in the pepin production. So pepin extraction can be done in the papaya. Pepin fruits which are about 90 to 100 days old, we can say fully mature but not ripe, mind it, are selected for the tapping in the morning hours before 10 a.m. 4 longitudinal incisions are given on the four sides of the selected fruit from the stalk and to the tip. The depth of the incision should be about 0.3 centimeter. On the incising, the latex starts flowing and this is collected in the suitable container, that is a araconut, spats, aluminum trays as well as glass vessels. Now, care should be taken not to use any other container for the pepin collection, since it will react. So, if we are using some metal vessels, then it may react with the pepin and rendering it unfit for the use. The latex that solidifies in the cuts should also be scraped carefully and added to the liquid latex. This process of making four incisions in the untapped fruit surface at 3 to 4 days interval is repeated thrice or four times over a period of 12 to 16 days. The latex thus collected every time should be dried in the sun or in the dryers at temperature ranging between 40 to 60 degrees Celsius. The time taken for the fresh latex to dry, or you can say solar drying, varied from about 1.5 to 36 hours. Now, potassium metabisulfite, that is 0.05%, is added to the liquid latex in small quantities before it is dried, since this helps to extend the storage life of the pepin, which is a final product. The drying of the pepin is continued until it comes off in the flakes having a porous structure. The dried pepin is powdered, sieved in a tense mesh sieve and stored in a polythene bags or in any other suitable containers for the better storage. Latex, whether dripped or congealed, dried as a pale yellow flax, which could easily be powdered and had proteolytic activities slightly higher than of the fresh latex. The biochemical analysis of the fruits revealed that latex extraction has no effect on the quality of the fruits. So, generally there is a belief that because of the extraction of the latex, generally fruits are having inferior quality may be negatively affected, but among this, after this biochemical analysis, it is found that such type of effect is not there in the on the papaya fruits. So, generally pepin yield, crude pepin from the plant yield 250 to 300 kilogram per hectare. So, this is the maximum yield that we can harvest, we can have from papaya, from the papaya field. Okay, so how we have to collect the latex? So this is a vessel, it may be leaves or sometimes plastics or anything other than metal. So these are the four incisions that the person is making. This is the incision, and this is the by this way artificially you can make the through the plastic or other than material, other than this metallic material, you can use this type of artificially made vessel and you can collect the latex. Okay, these are the incisions, this is the extraction of the latex from the papaya fruits. These are the incisions made in the on the papaya fruits. Okay, this is one and same, and this is the plastic vessel that we are collecting this latex. Okay, this is the one and same. So, how it is looking? It is dried, we can collect it. Okay, these are the some products which are available in the market on the basis of the papaya and this pepin. Okay, so friends, this is the end of this papaya crop, and I hope you have got all the information which is required for the papaya cultivation, papaya technology, and for the best and economical crop harvesting of the papaya. If you have any queries, then you can write me on my email. There is my email address is dilip_kanzria@yahoo.com, or on my mobile WhatsApp you can give me the questions 99797967761, or you can write something in the comments if you have any questions. Thank you, friends.